Hi guys, my name is Ferdy and in this video I will show you how you can create your own social media website using the plugin called Peepso. Let me show you what we will cover in this tutorial. I will show you how to create a social media website for your church, Tesla or affiliate marketing community, whatever you have in mind, so you can create a website that looks similar to Facebook. You can add sidebar widgets that will show your profile an overview menu, the latest members, the most used hashtags, the latest photos. I will show you how to change the color in your website or if you want to change the look and feel. You can also use a dark layout for instance. We will work with a lot of additions for the Peepso plugin, like adding photos, videos, adding a chat and messaging functionality, work with friendships in your community, create groups, polls, and so much more. I will show you how to reward active community members with points and badges based on their behavior so they can grow their status. And I will show you how people can buy things on your website with the points they earn. In that way, your community members are motivated to be active on your website. Of course, we will talk about monetizing your social media website so you can make some nice money with it and how to optimize your website for all devices. I want to be upfront with you. The theme and the plugin we will use in this tutorial are premium, and I have a coupon code that will give you 20% discount. And if you take a look at the comments, people seem to love those tutorials. So when you watch this video and you apply the things I teach you, you will have an amazing social media website in the end. In the description of the video, you can find timestamps. So if you want to go to a certain part of the tutorial, you can do that using the timestamps. If I go too fast for you in the tutorial, you can click on the icon here and lower the speed of the tutorial. If you like what you see so far, then please like this video and feel free to subscribe for more upcoming videos. When you hit the bell icon next to the subscribe button, you will get an update when I upload a new video. Having said that, let's get started. So the first thing we need to do is get a domain name and web hosting. If you have this already, that's great, then you can skip this part. If you have not, then you can go to webhosting129.com and then you can click on the button over here. Go to SiteGround. I love SiteGround. I host all my websites at SiteGround. SiteGround is, in my opinion, the best web hosting provider there is. And that is not only my opinion. In the Facebook web hosting group with more than 8,000 people, SiteGround is mentioned the most as best web hosting provider there is. And I agree with them. I scroll down a bit and here you see three plans you can choose. The best value for your money is the Grow Big plan. And the big difference between the startup and the Grow Big plan is that with the Grow Big plan, you can add unlimited domains to your account. With the startup plan, you can only have one domain. And all the time, people are upgrading later after they created their first website because they want to make a second website. So I suggest Grow Big. You have more than enough web space. You can have 25,000 visitors per month. And here you see all the other premium features. If you have more than 25,000 visitors per month, that is great. Then you can upgrade to the Go Geek plan. This is the plan I personally use, but for now, Grow Big is perfect. So I click here on Get Plan. And now we can choose a domain name. If you have a domain name already, you can click over here and fill that in. And then SiteGround will do a free transfer for you. And if you don't have a domain name yet, you can choose it over here. Here you can choose the extension. I suggest you use .com. And if I would say Facebook.com, here you can choose an extension. And I click on proceed, it will say, of course, that it is not available because it's already chosen. So let me say WordPress website tutorial.com. I click on proceed. Congratulations, domain www tutorial is available for registration with your hosting account. So I need to fill in some information over here and I start here with the email address. I say www.tutorial@30corpershook.com. A password. I repeat the password and then I need to fill in some information over here. My last name, my company name. Depending on which country you come from, I'm from the Netherlands, I need to fill in my VAT tax ID. That is only if you have a company. And then the amount of the taxes will be subtracted from the total amount you have to pay. And now I go to the city, my sluis, my street address, my zip code and my phone number. Then I scroll down and I can choose to pay with credit card or with a local payment provider from the Netherlands. So maybe you see something different over here and I would like to pay with credit card. So I fill in my details over here and then I scroll down. Here we see the plan we have selected, the data sender. I'm come from Europe, so I leave it at Europe. You can choose one if you want to. And the period. The longer you get web hosting, the more discount you get. I leave it at 12 months. I scroll down and I suggest you use domain privacy. That means that nobody sees that you can register a new domain. Because when people see that you have a new domain, they can send you spam emails like, hey, do you want a new logo? Do you want me to do SEO for you? You don't want that. This is an example. So I check this so nobody can see I have this email address and they cannot send me any spam. Well, the total amount is around 100 euros. It can depend where you come from, how much it is, but it's all around the same. I confirm that I've read and agreed to the SiteGround Terms of Service and Privacy Policy. And if you want to, you can receive SiteGround news and special offers by email. If you get web hosting through webhosting129.com, you don't pay more, but I get a commission. So thank you for that. And then you need to click on Pay Now. Your order was successfully submitted. Please hold it. It takes less than 2 minutes to complete. And the great thing is our website is live immediately. With other web hosting companies, it can take until 24 hours before your website is live. And with SiteGround, your website is live immediately. So I click on Proceed to Customer Area. And since we're here for the first time, we can click over here and click on Setup Site. I want to start a new website from scratch, so I click on Select. I scroll down and I want to have a WordPress website, so I click here on Select. Then I need to set up my login details, which will be www.tutorial@ferdykorpershoek.com, and I need to create a password. And then I click on Continue. I don't want to add the SiteGround scanner, so I click on Finish. And now my website will be created. It says you're all set. Your website with domain www.tutorial.com has been created. Awesome. Now I can go to the site tools by clicking over here, manage site. And when we go to www.tutorial.com, our website is live immediately. How amazing is this? I know it looks really ugly. We're going to make it really beautiful, but at this moment we are live already. But our website is not secure. And I want my website to be secure, and with SiteGround you can do that for free. So how do we do that? I close this and I click over here. Security, SSL Manager. And then I scroll down and here you see Manage SSL. If your website is not over here, you can install a certificate. So you select your domain and then say let's encrypt. But since it's the case already with us, I click over here on Actions. Enforce HTTPS. I turn this on and I turn this on. And now our website is secure. Now we can enter our website by going over here, go to my account, then go to websites, and then over here, www.tutorial.com. You can copy this, or we click on WordPress Kit and we click on WordPress Admin so we can log in. I click on Go. And now we can use our email address we signed up with, which is wwp-tutorial in my case, and my own created password. I click on Remember Me and I click on Login. And what you see now over here, our website is secure, and that is great. So here we see the WordPress starter. I don't use that, so I click on Exit. Now I want to clean up my website. So the first thing I want to do, I want to go to Plugins. I want to deactivate the WordPress starter and delete it. I click on OK. Then I go to the dashboard over here and I want to dismiss this and collapse this, collapse this, collapse this, and collapse this. I close this. And what I want to show you, what we are doing now, we are working in the backend of our website. When we are logged in, we have access to the backend. A website has a backend and a front end. This is what we will see when we are logged in. We can change things over here at pages, menus, configure our website. And when we click over here, click on visit site, then we go to the front end. Everybody at this moment that goes to www.tutorial.com will see this. It looks really bad, so we're going to fix this. But first, I want to adjust a few things. So the next thing I want to do, I want to go to the backend by clicking here. I go to Pages, All Pages, select this area. So we select all the pages and I click on Bulk Action, Move to Trash, Apply. Then I go to the trash and I want to empty the trash. I want to start with a clean installation of WordPress. What else? We can go to Settings, Permalinks. And at this moment, the custom structure looks really bad. So if I have a blog post that says, hi there, it will look like this, www.tutorial.com/index.php/the-year, the month, the day, and then hi there. So I want to make it simple, just www.tutorial.com/hi-there. I click on save the changes, and that's also better for the Google search results. The next thing I want to do, I want to go over here, click on edit my profile, and here we can change the colors of the backend. I like to keep it at the default. I scroll down, I want to fill in my first name, my last name, my email, which is this one. And then here at display name publicity as, I want to say Ferdy Korpershoek. And when I do that, take a look over here. So that makes it a bit more personal. Then I scroll down, I can enter some information over here, say something about myself. What you can do, you can create a Gravatar account, upload an image, and if you use the same email address over here as of your Gravatar account, then your image will display. So if I use my email address info@ferdykorpershoek, then my image will appear because at Gravatar I use the same image at info@ferdykorpershoek. I click on update profile. I need to confirm that my email address is changed over here. I click on approve. And now you see my image over here. Like that. So if you create a Gravatar account and use the same email address over here as on your Gravatar account, then you will see your image. And I think that looks amazing. What else? If I go to the dashboard, this is the overview of the backend. We can go to all kinds of places, add posts, media, pages, take a look at comments. We can change the appearance of our website, add plugins, add users. There are more tools, settings. And if we go to the front end, we still see this bar over here. This will only be seen when you are logged in. So if I would open the website, I go to backend and I open it incognito, I only see the website, I don't see the top bar. So over here at settings, I can go to general and here I can create my site title and my tagline. Well, I want to create a social media website around WordPress. So I say WP platform. And tagline for all WordPress users, something like that. In a few words, explain what this site is all about. Well, I like it to keep it like this. I scroll down, I can take a look at the date format, August 12, 2019, or change it or have a custom one. And the time format, I like to have 24 hours. So I say this one, 12:37. Save it. I need to log in again. Awesome. So our website is secure. Our profile is personal. The pages are deleted. We have a site title and we have great permalinks. And we will go to the dashboard overview. It all looks really organized. So what we can do now, at this moment, this is how our website looks. And I want to install the Peepso plugin. There's a free version. I'm going to show you how that works. So over here, I go to plugins, add new. And then we search over here for Peepso. And over here it appears. I click on install now. It's last updated 6 days ago, 3000 installs and going. I click on activate. And now it is activated. And what you see over here is Peepso. And we can go to getting started over here in the submenu. And if you take a look at pages in the new post, you don't have to go there. I will show you. Since we activated Peepso, Peepso made a few pages for us. So over here, you can see those pages here at getting started. Welcome to Peepso. And if we scroll down, I can see the community home. I can see members profile. So if I would go to community home and I hold command or control on the PC, I go to the recent activities. Well, since I'm the only member, this is everything I see at this moment. It says no posts found. Since I'm logged in WordPress, I am the first member. So it says member 30. So I can say what is on my mind. I say I am excited for this amazing tool. Click on post. And now this is the first post in the recent activities. Verdi Korpershoek, when did I write it? Just now. No image. This is the text and I can like it myself or love it or laugh about it. I love it. I can write a comment. You are so right, Verdi, as always. Post. So at this moment, I'm having an amazing time here at my own website with my own social media network, writing stuff myself to myself and responding to myself. What a blast. And I think I like this reaction and I can reply to it. I can edit it. So that's the beginning. What else can we do over here? We can go to the profile page. I open it in a new tab. And this is our profile. And what you see, it looks totally ugly. But I just want to show you what is possible. Later, we're going to use a different theme that is made for this plugin. And we're going to add so much more functionalities. But I want to show you the basics, what you can do with the free plugin. I click over here. I want to add an image, upload a photo, and I search for Verdi Korpershoek over here. I click on open. It's a little bit small, so I want to focus on my face. So I crop the image over here. And then I select this area. Something like that. Save the thumbnail. Like that. And then I click on done. Okay. Then I can click over here because I can add a header. Modify. Upload a photo. And then here at my desktop, when my wife was still pregnant. Now he's already 9 months. My son Noah. It takes a minute before the aspect ratio will be okay. So this is fine. And if you want to get the exact measurements, then you can upload something that has, let me show you, upload. That is 1280 by 480. That's the size of the header. So I click on open. So here he's in the tummy and here is out of the tummy. Update info. That looks weird. Okay. So what else? Over here at my profile page. I can complete my profile. So my first name, last name, I am a male. My birthday is the 28th of June, 1986. Apply. About me. I can say something about myself. Awesome. Do I have a website? I click on edit. HTTPS verdikorpershoek.com and I can go to the top, click on edit all, save all. Now it's all saved. So I can go to preferences, allow others to like my profile, hide my birthday, who can see me, everybody or only site members, who can post on my profile, site members or only me. Don't show my online status. I don't want people to see that I'm online and then, hey, Verdi, what is going on? So you can turn it off or on, whatever you want. Then we have notifications. Do I want to get an email or a notification on the website when something happens, when somebody writes a post on my profile, get an email and a notification on the website. When somebody comments, somebody likes your post, somebody likes your comment, when someone shares your post, when somebody likes your profile or mentions you in the post or mentions you in a comment. I turn it all on. And here we can disable all email notifications at once, like that. Also disable all notifications at once. And here we can turn them on, like that. Okay, then I go to account. Here's my username, my email. I can change my password over here. And I can export my community data. Okay. So Again, if I refresh this page with the recent activities, now it looks like this. I close it and I close this. So we have a registration page, a password recovery, password reset, external link warning. We can click on next, but before I do that, I want to go to the community home. I click on next and I can change the color scheme to dark. Now it's saved. So if I go over here, it is dark. Or you can change it to green, orange, red, blue. The corner shape, right now it's squared, we can make it rounded. Display name style or real names. The avatar square or round. I like it to be round. We can disable registration. I want to turn it off. I want to enable registration. And at this moment, I think this is okay. I click on next. And now we can add a few widgets. So if we go to our website, we still see nothing. But if we go to our community, we can have a few sidebars. So I click on customize. I can go to widgets. And you see there is no sidebar widget. Well, if you take a look at Facebook, we have sidebars over here, sidebars over here. I want it to be more like this. So how can we do that? We need to get the Gecko theme that is made by the people from Peepso. So I click over here, I go to the dashboard, and I go over here to ferdycorp.com/Peepso. Then we can go to pricing, and there are a few options. We have the free version, that is the social media network, but with no other tools. Then we have the ultimate bundle with all the extra plugins, like adding photos, adding a chat plugin. With the ultimate bundle, we can make something like Facebook. Not completely, of course, but it looks a lot like it. You've seen it in the introduction of the video. So I want to add this to the card. And that's not all. I want to click on the theme. I want to also get this, because if you take a look, this theme is made by the people from Peepso and it's perfectly integrated with the social media plugin Peepso. So I want to get that also. I click on it, add it to the cart. For how many websites? Just for one website. So I click on add to cart. I go to the checkout. So with this, you have everything to create a beautiful social media website, but I can give you a discount. So here it says, have a discount code, click to enter it. And if you enter 30 and you click on apply, you get 20% off and you pay $278.40. Scroll down, do you want to pay with credit card or with PayPal? Well, I want to pay with credit card. I leave my information over here, my email address, my first name, my last name, my credit card details. I scroll down, my billing address, I fill it in. The city where I live, the zip code, and the country. And I come from South Holland. I agree to everything and I click on purchase. When I get this through my affiliate link, I get a commission. So thank you for that. Awesome. Well, here I see my license keys. And here I can download the plugin. But first I want to download the Gecko theme. So I go to my downloads. And here it is, Peepso theme and Gecko one site license. I click on it and there it goes. So I go to the website, to appearance, themes. I can close this and I click on add new, upload theme, choose a file, go to downloads. And here it is. I click on open, install now. Then I click on activate. Okay, and now I want to click over here on theme details, delete, theme details, delete, and the latest one, theme details, delete. I want to keep everything clean. So this is our active website. We need to activate it over here, Gecko license. And in order to get it, I go to my downloads, my licenses, Peepso theme, Gecko, double click, copy. I paste it over here and I click on save changes. Okay, let's take a look at the front page. This is how our website looks. a bit better, but we're going to make it a lot better. I close this. And what I want to do now, I click on Customize. I want to customize the website, and it's easier to do that with the Gecko theme because it's made for the Peepso plugin. So the first thing I want to do, I want to scroll down to the homepage settings because it says nothing found. I want to change the latest post to static page. And the homepage, which Peepso made for us, I want it to be the recent activity page. Like that. I click on publish. And what you see over here, there are a few pages we have. So I want to show those pages over here in the top menu. So I close this and I go to appearance, menus. And I want to call this the main underscore menu. You can give this the name you want to. I like main underscore menu. Create the menu. And I'm going to assign a few pages to this menu. So here are the pages that are made by Peepso. I want to show groups, members, add them to the menu. Then I click on view all, the homepage, and that's okay. Add them to the menu. I can rename this by clicking here and say home, close it. And I can change the order by dragging this here to the top. You can also make a submenu. So if I bring this to the right, I scroll down. My display location is header menu. I save it and I click on visit the site. Now you see that this is a sub item of home. I don't want that, but I just want to show you that it is possible. Save the menu. Refresh. Awesome. Home. Members. Only for the Corpshoek at this moment, of course. And groups. And there are no groups yet. And for that, we need to add a plugin that we just bought. So I'll come back to that later. I go to the homepage. And I want to get rid of this title. How can I do that? I click on edit page. I can close this. And let me see here at the Gecko page options, hide the page title, update, view the page. And that looks better. Now I want to take a look at the sidebar over here. We can do it two ways. We can go to customize, scroll down, go to widgets. Let me see sidebar left. That is this sidebar. And here you see search. If I click over here and I remove that, then it is removed. And the other way, if I click on publish, I close it. And over here I go to widgets, and we are at the dashboard to appearance, widgets. You have the sidebar left, and here we have the sidebar widgets, and we can add them. So for instance, the Peepso profile, I click over here, I select sidebar left, and I click on add widget, and there it is. I don't want to have a title. Guest view is login form. I show notifications, show community links, and show the cover. And I click here and I want to drag it here above. Get rid of this. Of the recent comments. Archives. Categories. And meta. And then if I take a look on the website, we see our profile over here. I don't like it. So you can change the style. I click here and I can say Gecko options, widget style, box, border, gradient. I like bordered. Refresh. That's better. And now you see the header and the image. And if there's a new notification, I can click over here. So you see my profile, stream, about, preferences, community, activity, members, and logout. Okay, what else can we do? I close this and I click on customize. I scroll down and I go again to widgets. And then we have also the header widgets over here. Click on add widget. I search for user, Peepso user bar. Content position at the right. Guest view hide. What do we want to show over here? The avatar, the name, the notifications, user drop down menu, show logout icon, this one. No. show VIP icons and show badges. No. And I can also say gradient, and then you can see how it will look. Like that. Bordered. Box. Or none. Okay, I go back. We also can have a right sidebar. So sidebar right, add a widget. Let me see if I search for peep. So hashtags, latest members, login, online members. So let me say latest members. How many? 12. We can hide it when it's empty so you don't see it. Position, that's okay. And the style, we can have a gradient again. Or bordered. And if I publish it and I close it, it looks like this. So that's how it looks, a left sidebar, a right sidebar, and here the overview of our newsfeed. And when we will have more members and they post a lot of things on their page, then it will all be seen here in this overview. What I don't like over here are these colors, so I can change them here at the back end. Add Peepso, configuration, I go over here to appearance, color scheme, I want it to be light, and the corner shape, it is square right now, like this. I want to change it to rounded. I scroll down, I click on save the settings, and now if I refresh the page, this looks better in my opinion. And this also looks better, those rounded edges. So what else can we place over here? Well, I go back to customize, close this. I scroll down to the widgets and let me see, sidebar right. I want to take a look over here and I want to change this, the widget style to box, so it has a white background. I think that looks better. So what else can we add over here? Well, I can collapse this, click on add widget. Let me see, we can add a gallery, an image. Those are all coming with WordPress itself, but they're also Peepso plugin related widgets. So the latest members, well, we don't have members yet, but we can do that. Login, online members, who is online at this moment. Peepso profile we have over here, user bar. So let me see, hashtags. There are no hashtags yet, but we can get them. And I also want to change the style to box. So that's the same style over here. Well, what I don't like is that there are not so much options, but since we have the complete bundle of Peepso, we can add a lot of functionalities. So I click on publish, I close it here and I go to peepso.com. I go to my downloads. I click on this license, my ultimate bundle. And here we can add more functionalities. For instance, over here, if I want to add a photo, I cannot do that. But if I click on photos, download, you see it over here. So now if I go to the backend, holding command or control on the PC, plugins, add new. I click on upload plugin, choose a file. I go to my downloads. I open it and I click on install now Peepso core photos. So this is a core feature. I activate the plugin. Okay, let's take a look over here. I refresh the page and now we see the post type and there's an image. So now I can add a photo. I can click over here. I go to, let me see, the desktop. I can add this photo if I want to open it. I can say something. This is my beautiful son. This photo is taken in Aruba. We wanted to go to Aruba with our son that was 5 months old at that moment to show ourselves that we can travel the world with young children. We had a blast. I'm feeling really cool or happy or thankful. I click on post. And now we have our image over here. Awesome. So since we have this plugin, now when we go to customize, I close this and I scroll down and I go to widgets, right sidebar, sidebar right. I click on add widgets. And what we see now, if I say beep, so we have a new sidebar widget that comes with a photo widget, and that's the Peepso community photos. So I can click over here. Latest photos, 12 photos, and I want to have a box around it. And there's the latest photo, and that's from me because I'm the only member here and I just uploaded a photo. So with every addition over here, you get more possibilities. So until this moment, we used the premium theme Gecko. After that, we used the free version of Peepso. And now for the first time, we use the first add-on that we bought over here. But there are so much more. So let's talk about those. Before I do that, I want to take a look at another option. I go back to the sidebar left. This is everything to do with my own profile. So I want to add a widget. Let me see, Peepso, Peepso photos. My photos, limit to, let's say 9. Maybe a border. Like that. What I prefer to do, everything the same, boxed. And also this one, my profile, boxed. Like that. Publish, close it. So now it starts to look a little bit better already. So what we will do, we'll take a look at a lot of these additions, but before I do that, I want to configure a few more things. I want to get rid of this bar because here we have the homepage. Here we see the members. We also see them here. My profile is also seen over here, just as this and this. So how can I get rid of this area? I go to the backend, to Peepso configurations. I can close this. Then I go to appearance. And then here at general, disable Peepso navigation bar. I scroll down, I click on save the settings. Open the website in a new tab. And now it is gone. So if I click over here, I see stream about photos, and we see photos because we have the photo add-on. So the more add-ons you add over here, the more options you get. And what you can do, if you don't use this, but you rather use this bar over here, you can add this overview over here. How can we do that? Configurations, scroll down here, still at appearance. Below, disable Peepso navigation bar, replace WordPress admin navigation bar. Yes. I save it. And we refresh the page and we hover over here. We see photos preferences just like here. But what I rather have when somebody is a visitor, I rather have that they never see this bar, that they can adjust everything over here. How can we fix that? We scroll down to Gecko. I click on it. And then here at general, show WordPress admin bar never. So if I save this and I refresh this page, the top bar is gone, but I need it because I want to go to the backend now and then. So what will I say? I change never to only to administrators. So I'm an administrator, but everybody that signs up is not an administrator. So I will always see this bar over here, but the visitors and new registered people will not see that bar, which looks much better in my opinion. If I will bring this back, so over here at Peepso configurations, appearance, I turn this off, I save it. So what does it mean? Over here, I will see the normal menu and not this one. I refresh the page like this. What I see now is this image. I can replace this image by the avatar from my profile. And it will happen with all the members, so nobody has to get a Gravatar account in order to get their image over there. I go to Configurations, Appearance. I scroll down to Avatar and Colors, and here I say use Peepso Avatar everywhere. So I save the settings. And now over here you'll see an image of myself with a white background. Like that. So let's take a look at hashtags. If I go to my first post, I click over here, I click on edit post. And after that I say hashtag amazing. You see, it becomes a blue area, post. And now this is officially a hashtag. So everybody on this website that uses the hashtag amazing, when you click on it, you will see an overview of everybody that is using that. And now you should see it also over here. So if I go to the homepage and also over here, edit post, I do a hashtag vacation. And I click on post. Now this is a hashtag. So if I will refresh this, it should show the latest hashtags. So we see the hashtag over here. I refresh the page. And it can be that you do not see the hashtags immediately. And that's because here at configuration, when you go to stream posts, here at hashtags, it says it is enabled, but it takes around 60 minutes before they get updated. Well, in this case, it only took 4 minutes. So that's great. I think they're a little big. And if you want to make them smaller, click on customize. Go to widgets. They're probably so big because there are the only two, and it is a cloud. If we take a look at sidebar right, hashtags, it is a cloud. So if I would say list, they will be smaller. If I would say mixed, they are bigger. So the more hashtags there are, the better it will look. So I keep it at cloud. And I click on publish. So I want to add an advertisement, because if you have an amazing community with a lot of people that are active over there, you can add advertisements and make quite some money with it. So I click on add a widget and I search for an image. Here at the right image, I can say title, web hosting, for instance. I click on add image, select a file. And here at the desktop, I have a file from SiteGround, open it. And then here I have the link. So I grab my affiliate link, add widget, add to widget. And there it is. And I want to make it boxed. I also can remove the title. And then look like that. Publish, close it. So you see, it starts to look better and better. We have our profile area. We have the newsfeed. We have the latest members, the community hashtags, the latest photos, and an advertisement. So at this moment, we can do so much things. I can take a look at the logo, at the layout. I can add more add-ons over here. So what I want to do now, I want to add more add-ons, and then I want to take a look at the layout. So what else do I want to add? Audio and video is a possibility, but keep in mind that when you have this on your website, that it can take a lot of space, because this is not about embedding a YouTube video. It's really about uploading your own videos to your own website, to your own server. So I rather do not use this. We can also add more additions, but a lot of additions are related to multiple members, and I only have one member. So before we continue with this, let's take a look on how people can become a member in your Peepso community. So what I want to do now, I want to open this page as an incognito person. So I go to the dashboard, I go to visit site, right mouse click, open in incognito. So it removes all the cookies, so it doesn't see I'm logged in. This is the page people will see. And if you want to change this page, let me show you. You can go to Peepso, getting started, go to customize, scroll down, and here you can say, come and join our WordPress community. Save it. Join us now, it's free. I can change the image, but I will leave it as it is. I click on next. So now I go back to that page, refresh, come and join our WordPress community. So I want to join for free. I click on it and I say my username is Anna. My email address, I need to verify it, and my password twice, and I click on register. I will skip this part. What I will do now, I will register 4 new members, add some posts, and then I will be back with you. So I added a few profiles. Over here you can see them. When you hover them, you see their full name. You can click on them, then go to the profile. And here you see what she has posted, her own profile picture. If I click on home or on the logo, then I go to the news feed. So what I see over here is a green dot. That means that Deborah Johnson is currently online. And that is because here at Safari, I'm logged in with her name. I don't know. I hope I do not make it too confusing. But let me go to my own profile in Chrome. And here it says, hi guys, how can I transfer a WordPress website to a new domain? What I can do now, I can go to YouTube. And I can search for 30WP Vivid. Right mouse click, copy the link address, close it, and then I can say, hi Deborah, here is the solution, wink, paste the code, post it. What do you see? The video is embedded like that. I can also like it or love it or whatever, celebrate it. I like it. I can also say I report it. The reason is I don't like this question, I don't know. And since I'm an administrator, I can pin this to the top. So I can say, you know what, this should be seen by everybody. So now it's pinned, it has a beautiful border around it. And if somebody else uploads something or posts something new, this will still be pinned. Let me show you. Unpin. Right now, this is the most recent message. If I pin this, it is now on top. So that's how it works. Unpin. What you also see that there's a new tag over here. Love my life. And since it's used twice, it is bigger than amazing and vacation. So what we can do now here at Peepso Ultimate, I can add new add-ons. And if I want to know what something means, I can click on it. And then I see a clear explanation. Over here I see chat messages. I bring it back. I can download it. But what I want to do first, I want to go to Giphy. And if I click on it, I can reply with animations. So if I want to add it, since we have the ultimate bundle, I just download it. I go to the website, to the backend, and here at plugins, I click on add new. Upload plugin, choose a file, and here it is, Giphy. Open it, install now, activate it, I close it here. And now if I go to the website and I go to the beautiful lion, I click on write a comment, and now I can comment with a photo because we have added that as a plugin, and with a GIF file. So I can select this one. What? Post it. What? That looks amazing. With Jennifer Lopez saying, what? That looks amazing. I can love this. So let's go back to the other add-ons. I want to add friends. People can become friends from each other. So I click on download. Meanwhile, I go to the backend, plugins, add new. upload plugin, choose a file. And maybe you don't need it. Maybe you are having a church membership website and then you don't need to be friends of each other because everybody should already be friends from each other. Or maybe it's a membership from your soccer club, or you all had a baby the last 12 months and you have a community around that. But if you have a really big community, of course, then you can have friendships because not everybody wants to be related with each other. So I click on open, install now. And by the way, over here, there's nothing about friends and I can see everybody's post. I see them from Anna, from Deborah, Noah, from Janet, all of them. But when I activate the plugin, I close it here and I click on refresh. I see friends over here. I have no friends, but I can go to Deborah, she's online, and I want to add her as a friend. So I click on add friend. Then I go to Safari where I'm logged in with Deborah. And what I see over here and over here, Freddy liked my post, Freddy commented on my post. So that's nice. But where's the friend request? Here's the friend request over here and over here. I can see it. So I click here. I think Freddy, yeah, let's approve it. So if I refresh it, I go to my profile, I click on friends, and it says she has one friend. And when I go to Chrome, where I'm logged in as Ferdy, and I refresh the page, it says that Deborah has accepted my friend request. One more thing, we are here at the profile page of Deborah. If I click on edit page, I want to disable the title. So over here, hide page title, update, view the page. And now you don't see Deborah over here because you see it already here. And here you see the name. So if I would click on Deborah's profile, you don't see that over here anymore. Click here. She accepted it. Okay. I can also say I mark everything as read. And I just received an email that said, hello, Ferdy Korpshoek, Deborah Johnson accepted your friend request. And I can watch her profile over here. And I can manage my preferences over here. And then I automatically go to notifications and it says on site that was this notification over here and an email. So that's how it works. So when I go to the homepage, I have only one friend, but I also still see things from Anna, Noah, and everybody else. Why is that? Because over here, I can click on community and it says post from the entire community. I can see everybody's post. So everybody that's in this community, I'll see their posts. Or I can say, I only want to see posts from the people that I'm following. If I click on apply, I only see things from Deborah. And if I would click on Janet, I'm not a friend with her, but I can follow her, start following without being a friend. And if I go to the homepage and I scroll down, I see her updates also. So that's what you can do. You can become friends. And to take it a step further, I can be a friend and stop following. So now if I go to my homepage, I only see things from Janet. I'm not a friend with her, but I follow her. I am friends with Deborah, but I do not follow her. So those are two separate things. I want to follow Janet again. I just click here on start following. I can also click here. I can block her, I can report her, and I can ban her because I am an administrator. So let's talk a little bit more about hashtags. There's one more thing about it. Over here, love my life, when I click on it, I see all the posts from people that have said love my life. But it says no post found. Why? Because it selected all the people that I'm following. But if I would say the community and I click on apply, then I can see everybody that said love my life, love my life. I go back to the homepage. I can say hide my posts, so I only see other people's posts in this overview. So I can search for the exact phrase guys, search, and there it is, guys. So if you're searching for a subject or for something that somebody says, you can say the exact phrase or any of the words. So if I would say guy, let me see, guy and love my life, search, I see guys or guy and I see love my life. Awesome. What else can you do? That's for the visitor. You can schedule posts. So you can say there is a new tutorial and you can say I want to schedule it for in a few days on a certain time and then click on done and then it will automatically be posted. So as you see, it looks amazing already, but we're going to make it even better. I close this and I drag this to the left. I go to Peepso Ultimate. Let me show you what I want to have. Photos we have, audio and video, I skipped that. We have friends, chat. If you want to know more, click on it and then you get more information. So I want to download the chat. First, I want to clean up this area. So I want to add chat. Then I wait until it's downloaded and then I want to add groups. Then I want to add polls. I want to add email digest, so every week all the members get an email with the most popular updates of members. You can add a word filter if you want to, so if people say certain words, the update will not be placed. Auto friends, that means that friends are automatic. Edit, I will skip that. User limits, VIPs, I want to use that. I want to use MyCred integration. And keep in mind that when you use integrations, that it is not the plugin itself, but it's an integration. So if it says paid membership pro integration, then you need to have paid membership pro. Advanced ads integration and WooCommerce integration. And also badges integration. So there are quite a few. I go to the website, to the backend, and I need to upload them one by one. So I go to plugins, add new, upload plugin, choose a file. I go for the first one, install now. Then I go to return plugin installer, upload, choose two, install, return. It's not the greatest thing to do, but it needs to be done and you only have to do it one time. The third one, install, I close this. Return, fourth one, and then the latest one. Open, install, then I go to install plugins, I select them all, bulk action, activate, apply. If we go to the website, we see so much more options over here. And if we go to the page groups, no groups found, but you don't see that code anymore. So it means it is active. So some plugins need other plugins. So we need the WooCommerce plugin. I go over here to the backend, plugins, add new, search for WooCommerce plugin, install, activate. I want to skip this, not right now. What else? Batch OS. So I go to plugins, add new, batch OS, install, activate. What else? My cred, add new, paste it. There it is, install, activate, and advanced ads, add new. paste it. And here it is. A lot of installations. 5 stars. Updated 3 weeks ago. Activate. So if I refresh the page, we need to do a few things. Welcome to WooCommerce. I click on skip setup. Close this. Dismiss this. I need to run the setup over here. I'll do this later. So I click on create points. Setup complete. I go to the dashboard. I close all this stuff. I go to pages. I need to do one more thing for WooCommerce. I need to go to WooCommerce, status. Then I go to tools. I scroll down a bit. And I search for create default WooCommerce pages. Create pages. Awesome. Now when we go to pages, we see the cart page, checkout page. Perfect. So if I go to the dashboard, it's a bit more crowded over here, but we're going to work with everything step by step. So I go to the website, I close this, and I close this. So what will we do next? Since the chat plugin is activated, I can click over here, and there are no notifications. But if I click on Deborah, I can click over here. I can start a chat with her. Hi there. And then here on her profile, I see this message popping up. Hi. So I go back to my Chrome and I see the reaction. And now if I go over here, I see my message history with Deborah. If I want to configure this, I can go to the backend. Peepso, configurations. And here you see all the configurations of all the plugins we added. And the blue ones are the core. Those are extra and those are integrations of other plugins. So I click on chat. Enable read notification. If you turn it on, that means that when you send a message and the other person read it, you will see that that person read it. Allow new messages only from friends. Yes. Otherwise, everybody can send you a message. This can be overruled in your own personal preferences. And the character limit per message is 4,000. Then we have the chat. Enable chat. Yes. Forced long poll. If you turn this on, that means when you have an open chat window and you go to a different page, that there also the message still is available. And I can disable the chat on certain pages. So if I go over here and I get a message, hi, then it opens over here. And if I go to members, it will still be open unless I say I don't want the chat window to be seen on the members page. So I place it over here like that. Save the settings. Now I go to the home page. You will see it. But if I go to the members page, you will not see it. So that's what you can do over here. And since you are here at the members page, this is also a way for you to get in contact with people. So here at AnnaCorp, I can click on it. And here it says that I received a message from Deborah. So I remove this again, save the settings, refresh the members page. So there it is. And now I can click over here and then I can send a message to Anna. Hi, Anna. So that's how it works. I can click over here, turn off the chat, mute the conversation, feel the full conversation. I can close this, and then here I can continue. Hi there. So that's with the chat. And talking about configuration, for every addition, there are configurations, but there's also the normal configuration. But before we are going to talk about that, there's also still the customize option. So I go to the homepage and I want to configure this even more because there are purple colors. Maybe I want to change those. How can you do that? Let me show you. I click on customize. Now I want to talk about all the customize options. And we start with site identity. I want to add a logo. I can upload it or I can drag it over here. Remove the dash, copy the title and paste it. Select, skip cropping. And voila, there it is. It's a little bit big. I don't like the size. I want to have the same for the mobile. And I want to have a site icon. Upload files. And here at the desktop, fav icon. Select, skip cropping. And the logo should redirect to the homepage, of course. So to the recent activities. Okay. Publish. I go back. I go to the colors. The primary color, well, in Photoshop, I have the background. So I press the I. I go to the lighter area, grab this color, and that will be my primary color. So a lot of things that are purple will become blue. The shade color, I want it to be the dark color. I can also go over here and grab the darker color. Place it here. Also here, I paste it. Alternative color, maybe greenish. I copy this one just in case. Then we have the default text color. I think that's perfect. Or you know what? I bring it to the left, make it gray, bring it down a bit, and bring this down. So it will be really gray. Text light color, that's okay. I go back, general, the link color, this one, but a bit a different color. Link hover can be this one again. Background color, if I change that, you know what? Maybe a little bit grayish. Not too much. We can also have an image and then we can configure the image. Scroll to top button. So if I scroll down, you see this button over here. I like that. Okay. I can also have the dark mode. So if I turn this on, it will look like this. Totally different look and feel. So maybe if you have a gaming website, you can change that. I click on publish. I want to close this. And this is way too big. So what I want to do, I want to change the logo. So I click on customize. Site identity. Remove. I click on upload. Select logo WP platform. Open. Select skip cropping. And that should do the trick. It still looks a little bit weird. Publish, close it. That looks better. I click on customize. We'll take a look at this area later. I want to take a look at the layout. It can be boxed. So if I make the smaller, command minus, 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 minus. That's really small, make it a bit bigger. I can say boxed. Then you don't have the background anymore. Turn this off. Change the width of the website. I think this is perfect. We can have a full width layout if I check that. And I make this smaller. You see everything is still totally at the left over here and totally at the right. I don't like that. Turn this off. Hide sidebars on a mobile. Yes. So if I go to the mobile view, you only see this area. hide footer widgets on the mobile. Yes. So it's all focused on the social media network. Better. The content column width, the area in the center, I can make it bigger, but I think 50 is fine. Okay, let's go to the header. The static header. We can disable it, we can enable it. And if we do so, when we scroll down, the menu sticks with us. Well, what does Facebook do? They stick with us. So I will also do that over here. The menu position after search or after the widget, totally at the right, or default. I like default. Menu alignment at the left or at the center or at the right. Left is perfect. Do we want to have a blend mode? So it all looks one menu and it blends in with the background. No. We can change the background color. The link color. Header active link color. So I go to Photoshop. And I grab this color again. Header search input background. It can be a little bit lighter. And the separators, you know what? I want them to be white. I don't want to see them. Burger icon. So when you're on a different device, how should it look? It should have this color, grayish or blue. And when we hover over it, it should be darker blue. Mobile menu background color. This one, I think this is perfect. Link colors are light, as you see over here. Mobile submenu link color, this color, perfect. Top and bottom widgets. We don't have widgets yet, so I will skip the footer. Widget styles. Well, we can have a gradient, and if you want that, then you can change the colors over here. Grab this one. Then I want to grab the other one. Copy it. And paste it here. Gradient text color white, gradient links color white, gradient links and hover color. Maybe a little less white. Publish. So if I would close this and I customize it again, and I scroll down, go to the widgets, to the left one, and at profile, I say, change the style to gradient, it will have my blue colors. Like that. I bring it back to box. And I go back and back. Let me see, widget styles, Peepso. Let's take a look at those colors. Pinned post color, again. Not the dark one, but the light one. Default button text color. That's this one. Perfect. Default button background color. That's this color, I guess. And a hover. Well, this looks like a button, so you can change those colors if you want to. The action button text color, white, action button background, this one, and on hover, it becomes a little bit darker. The menus, all perfect. The widgets, we talked about that. The homepage settings, we talked about that. WooCommerce, we will talk about it later. Additional CSS and custom JavaScript. Okay, I click on publish. And one more thing, I go to general and the link colors, I bring it back to blue because now everybody's greenish and I want it to be blue, just like the logo. Awesome. Publish. And I close it. and that looks much better. As you see, I fixed the logo of the website. How did I do it? I go to the dashboard, go to media. It was a little bit of trial and error, as you see. And this is the final one, 395 by 82 pixels. And that seems to be working fine, also on the mobile, so I'm happy. What I want to do now, I want to take a look at my profile page or any profile page. If I click here on Deborah Johnson, you see a profile page within our website with the sidebars. If I want to change that, I can do that. I can see her stream. I can click on About, Friends, etc. But what I want to do, I want the profile page to look different. So I click on Edit Page. And I want to take a look over here at the Gecko page options. I've hidden the page title already. I want to hide, let me see. No, I just want to hide the sidebars on the mobile, but also here. Hide both. Okay, I also can go to the page attributes and then say I want to have this as a landing page or a user profile. If I don't do that and I click on update, so I only hit the sidebars, I click on view the page. Now I see my own profile. It looks like this. My stream, my about information, preferences, notifications. You know what? I will log in. As Deborah, and then I want to go to a different user, Anna. This is now what I see. Her stream, her about information, no data. The amount of friends, no friends. The photos of her, two. The groups, she has not assigned to a group yet, and the badges. Here you see the amount of profile views and the amount of profile likes. If I want to change that, well, first, I want to take a look at the profile. Maybe I want to have a left sidebar. I can say hide right, update, refresh. So I always see my own sidebar here. So I can navigate wherever I want. And then I can see the profile of Anna. So I think this is awesome. Here we can add her as a friend. We can start following her. We can block her reporter. So that's okay. Now I want to go to the settings here at Peepso, configurations, and then appearance. And it says here user profiles. I want to display the real names, not the usernames. User can override display name style. So they can say, I want to choose my nickname instead of my real name. I'd rather use with real name, so I say no. People can permanently delete their profiles. Yes. Should people be allowed to share the profile? Yes. Profile likes. No. Why should you like a profile? No. I turn this off. That's what you see over here. Profile likes. So I will save it later and I will show you how it looks. Always link to Peepso profile. No. My avatar shape, I want to be round. Use WordPress avatars. No. Use Peepso avatars everywhere. Yes. Allow Gravatar avatars. No. Always use full covers. I save the settings, and what you'll see now, if I refresh the page, look over here, we cannot like this anymore. So I go to my own profile page, and it looks like this. I can go to the home page, to the stream. And I click on Noah, for instance. And then I see his profile like this. And no matter where I am, I can always navigate to something else. So that's what you can do with the profiles. What I don't want in my website is that when I go to the homepage, that a lot of people do not have a profile image. This is perfect for me. But if you only see the standard icons with no pictures, you can do something about it. You can demand from people to upload a profile picture before they can get access to all the features of the website. How can you do that? I go to Peepso, My Downloads. I go to My Ultimate Bundle. And there I download user limits. I download it. There it goes. I go to plugins, add new, upload plugin, choose a file. I go to my downloads. Let me see. User limits. Open it. Install now. And I activate the plugin. Now I go to Peepso, configuration, and I go to user limits. What I can do over here, I can say that everybody that comes through gmail.com cannot apply for a profile. But I see no reason why I should do that. And first I need to enable that. I can also whitelist people. So everybody with Gmail can create an account. But if I turn this off, everybody with a Gmail account and other accounts can sign up. Hide users from listings. So I can say all the administrators should never be seen in all the listings. So then over here, I will be gone because I'm an administrator. I can also base it on profile completeness. So if I would say you need to complete at least 80%, otherwise you will not be shown. If I save it and I refresh the page over here and I go to the members, I'm the only one that is being seen because this profile is only 33%, just as all the other profiles. So if I want to hide myself, I can also say yes over here, hide all the administrators, save the settings, and now refresh this page. And you see nobody. So I turn it off. I say no limit. What I can say that I want everybody to have an avatar and a cover. If they don't have that, they will not be shown in the website. So I refresh and there will only be one person, and that is Freddy Korpshoek. Like that. So if I go to Deborah Johnson and I click over here, modify, upload a photo, and I grab this image. And I go to members, I will be seen, Ferdy and Deborah, because I have a profile picture and a cover image. So that's how it works. I like that. Selected users will not be able to create any new posts that includes posting in groups. Administrators can't be limited. So here again, based on the avatar, if they don't have it, they cannot post anything. So again, I want to turn this on everywhere. They cannot send any friends request. Or disable groups. Or chat. So let me check it. Save the settings. And I refresh the page. And I want to send the chat message to Ferdy. Hey, what's up? I can do that. And if I go to my profile, I just got a message. But if I log out and I log in as Anna, it says you're currently not allowed to create new posts. So if I go to Ferdy, I cannot send a chat message. If I go to members, I cannot send anything. Why? Because I have not updated my profile yet. So if I click over here, I upload an image, something like this, our new house where we're going to live. Now, if I go to members, I can add people as a friend, start following them. So there are now more options because I have my profile picture and my cover image. So there's something that you can do over here. Add Peepso configurations, user limits. I go to the plugins and I search for limit. I deactivate it because I want everybody to have all the possibilities in the website, all the features. So what I want to do now, I want to go to Peepso configurations, groups. Enable group creation. Okay, since it's enabled, I can go to AnaCorp, refresh the page, and I can go to groups. And if you can see it, if you don't have that in the menu, you can go over here to groups. You don't belong to any group yet. So I can click here on create group or go here to groups and create group. Enter your group's name. Well, mothers with kids. I don't know. A mother has a kid, so mothers with kids is maybe not necessary. Young mothers. I don't know. Do you have a child? Let's talk about everything we are going through. We can have three options. It can be open for anybody to sign up. It can be closed, so you need to get an invite or request the group membership to be accepted. Or it's secret and you can only get an invite. So I say it's closed. Create a group. I can say, hi ladies. Share what you love the most about being a mother and what is the hardest thing for you to be a mother. Post. And then people can respond to it. So now when I go to groups, I see this group. Also when I go as Ferdy, groups. And by the way, and you see here in the overview that Anna posted something in the Young Mothers group. So I'm interested and I want to join. So now I go to Anna's profile because she's the owner of this group. And I see that Ferdy has joined the group. And I don't want that to be so easy. I need to be accepted. So what I need to do, I go to Google Chrome, to the backend. I go to configuration. I go to groups. Enable group creation, yes. Enable post updates upon group avatar change, yes. Enable post updates upon group change, yes. So when there's a new member, should it be shared on the stream? No. Automatically subscribe new members to notifications. So if there's something new in the mothers group, I get a notification and I get an email. I can turn off email and turn on notifications. Group listing, show the owners, yes. Show the creation date, no. Allow guest access, no. And default sort, recently added, so the newest members are on top. Default sort direction, descending, perfect. What else? Categories. Enable group categories. No. Unless you have a really big website with a lot of groups, then you can enable group categories. So for instance, wealth, health, relationships. Set group categories as default view. Well, since I do not use this, I don't want to use that. Allow multiple categories per group. So there can be the group mothers that will be in the category relationships and the category health. Category listing. Well, since we're not working with category, you can figure out how everything works. I think that's okay. SEO, use slugs in group URLs, yes. Advanced, pin to top only inside groups, yes. So if something is pinned to top, for instance, I go to the groups, young mothers, and I, as an administrator, I want to pin this to the top. Then only in this group it will be pinned to the top. So yes, I need to save this because now it's also available over here. Replace invite with add for admins. You can do that. Email admins when a new group is created. Yes, I like to see what kind of new groups are created. Show membership summary for group names on stream. No. Save settings. I go to the groups, young mothers, and I want to unpin this. And now I can say, I am a father, but I love everything about it. It's not true. Sometimes I'm tired. Sometimes I miss spending time with my wife at night or going somewhere. But then we need to get a babysitter and we don't do it often. So, and by the way, this is a fake picture. This is not my wife. So, just so you know. I go back. What else can we do? Another feature of the Peepso Ultimate Bundle is the polls. You can add polls to your website. So I go to the backend. Here at configuration, I go to polls. Multi-select polls. Can we select more answers? No. Polls in groups. Polls are available in group posts. Yes. Allow vote change. No. So when somebody clicks on the answer, he cannot change it anymore. And always show the results. No. You only see the results when you gave your vote. That's the whole idea of a poll, that people will fill it in so they can see the results. So now I have that. I go to Safari. I refresh the page and I want to have a poll. So over here, post type, poll. What is your favorite color? Option one, blue, red, green, orange, purple, yellow. So I'm like, this is okay. I click on post. AnaCorp has asked a question. What is your favorite color? So I go to the website. No votes yet. So I say orange. I click on submit. Okay. Then I log out. I log in with Deborah. And I see no results yet. But if I would say blue, submit, then I see the results. And then I can add a GIF, blue, something like that. I don't know. Awesome. And if I go to Anna's personal profile, I see it here in her stream. Let's take a look at the registration page. If I open this in a new incognito window, that means that I'm not logged in anymore. This is what someone will see when he enters this website for the first time. Join us now, it's free. So I can click on register. And then I can have my username, my email, verify email, password, and verify my password. But I can configure this. So I close this, I go to the backend, Peepso configuration. And here in general, I scroll down. I can disable registration. So if you have a closed community and nobody can register, you can turn this on. Repeat email field. So people need to fill in their email address twice so it can be confirmed that it's the right email. I can disable the email verification. So I will do that right now. Admin account verification. That means that I, as an administrator, need to accept them personally when they register for an account. Force profile completion. Well, I like that. So they need to fill in everything before they can participate in the community. Activation redirect. After they are activated, they just can go to the website. Force SSL on registration page. Yes. We can enable reCAPTCHA. When you do that, you need to have a side key and a secret key. I have a tutorial about that. You can find it over here. And you can have terms and conditions. You can write them over here and a privacy policy. Hi there. Hi there. Save the settings. So now when I go to Safari, I log out. I can sign up over here. Join us, it's free. I need to fill this in and now I need to agree with the terms and conditions and the privacy policy. And I can register. Then they're a member immediately, but they need to fill in everything before they get access to the community. If I take a look over here, this is the page register. We can also do something else. here at the pages. I search for register. I open it. It's a simple shortcode over here. So here at document, I can say template should be user profile or something else. Or over here, I can say hide both sidebars, update, and then it looks like this. So there is less distraction. You can also say, I want it to be a landing page. Update, refresh, and then it looks like this. So you can log in or you can register. Well, then I should definitely change the background because the colors are really bad. So how can I do that? I go to the featured image, select a featured image. I go to pexels.com. I search for community. Yeah, why not? Grab this one, free download. I personally like to open it in Photoshop. Close it. Then I want to add a new layer that is bluish like that. And then I go to the fill. I change it like that, or I go to the blending modes. Something like that. Then I duplicate it, Command J, bring it to normal. And maybe this one should be white. File, export, save for web legacy. Over here, I change the width to 9020. Change it to JPEG. 70 is okay here at the quality. Save it. I go to the desktop, community background. I go to the website and I drag it over here, or I can click on upload files. And I select it. Update. Let's take a look. Refresh. I'm still not really happy with it. Site registration, username, email. So maybe even a better thing to do, replace it. Update. Refresh. Something like that. So people can fill this in. Email, verify, password. Agree to everything. And then register. And then they need to complete their profile before they can get access to all the beautiful stuff. And if you don't want that, you want to have a normal register page, you can bring this back to default template. Okay, guys, it's time to add some gamification in this platform. Why? Gamification is a thing that helps people to stay connected. I play FIFA Ultimate Team. It's a soccer game on the PlayStation. And when I win games, I get points. And with those points, I can buy better players. And with those better players, I can win more and buy better players. It's a little bit addictive, but that's gamification. And we can apply the same principle on our website. So when somebody logs in, when somebody fills in a poll or reacts on a post, they get points for that. And with those points, they can get a certain status or they can buy things. So let me show you how we can do that. We installed already MyCred. So if I go to Peepso, My Downloads, Your Ultimate Bundle, you see here the MyCred integration, and here at the back end, we installed MyCred itself and the integration. So what we can do now, I want to go to the website. I click on Customize, and I want to add some points over here. I want it to be here at the top so it's visible. And I go to widgets, sidebar right, add a widget, my cred, my balance. It shows the amount of points I have. So I say points and I want to drag it up over here. So it will be here. Then I want to change the style, of course, to how about gradient? So it gets a little bit more attention. Yes, I think that's awesome. I click on publish and I close it. But I see we have 0 points. So how can we get points? Well, we need to configure ourselves how people can get points when they log in, when they enter the website, when they reply on things. So how can we do that? We go to the backend. I scroll down and then I go to points, hooks. And with those hooks, we can give people points based on what they do. Points for registration. When people register, they get points. I think that's a good thing because then they immediately see that you can get points. So when you register, you get 10 points. Save it. But we cannot check this because we are already registered. So points for reaching a year. A user has been a member. No. Points for daily visits. Award points for visiting your website on a daily basis. How many points? 5 points for the site visit. Points for logins. Points for publishing content. Publishing a post gives you 5 points. This gives you no points. There can be a limit. Let's say maximum of 5 per week. Otherwise, people can post a lot of things and they get so many points. So you can give it a limitation. Points for comments, so people will be motivated to comment. How about 3 points? Limit per day, 9 and 3. Save it. Points for clicking on links, add a hook. When people click on the link, they get 1 point. Once for each unique URL. Save it. I click on Peepso. Points for new Peepso post. Limit of 5 per day. You know what? 5 per time. 10 per day. A message through Peepso gives you 1 point. So let's create some points. And of course, you can take a look at this all and create your own point system. Let me take a look at Badge OS. Edit. To earn a badge, you need to have 25 points. Let's say 15 points. So let's take a look at Badge OS. If I take a look at badges. So if I go to the website, I have 5 points already. I don't know exactly how I got them, but if I say I love orange because it is a warm and happy color, and the Netherlands wears orange when they play soccer. Woohoo! Post. So if I refresh the page, I have 6 points because I commented over here. When I say I added a point system so people can achieve certain things and buy things in the website with the points they earn, something like that. Post. Refresh. Now I have 11 points. So the point system is working now. You see, people can see it easily. And when they see they get more points, it can motivate them to react on people. So if I like this, or I love this, also here, you can assign points to that so people can get more points and it can motivate them to be more active on this website. We can also assign badges to those points. I did a few things. I have now more points. How can I assign a badge to getting a certain amount of points? I go to the backend. I scroll down and I go to Badge OS. I go to Badges. And I add a new badge. I call this badge Level 1, something like that. I scroll down and I go to the achievement data. And I can give points for achieving this badge. So if they reach 50 points, for instance, I can say because you reach it, you will get 20 more points. So you go from 50 to 70, let's say 10. Earned by completing a certain step or minimum number of points. So when the minimum number of points is 50, they will get this badge. We can show the earners. No. Congrats on reaching Level 1. How many times can people earn this badge? Only one time. Show it to the user, and if there's an attachment, you can add it to it. Okay, awesome. I want to add a featured image. Uploads, select a file, and I want to add honey. I got this from flaticon.com. I need to give credit to the maker, so let's go to flaticon. Let's see where it is. It is from the Sauna Icon Pack by FreePick. So now you know. So I will download another one. Let me see. PNG, give credit. There it goes. So I want to add this. Close this and publish it. I go to the website. And when I have 50 points, I will get this new badge. You can also assign badges a different way. So I go to the backend. I go to Badge OS, Badges, new one. A good friend is the badge title. And this time, I want to add a new step. So let me see. Here below, earned by completing steps. Then I need to go up again, add a new step. And it can be to log in into your website for the 50th time, or commenting on a post, or let me see, Peepso community engagement. And then there are more choices. When you add a new friend or when you send a friend request one time or five times. Let's say one time, friend. Let me see how it's called over here. A good friend. I paste it, save all the steps. Do you get points for it? Yeah, let's say 10 points earned by completing a step. This is all fine. You can earn it one time, not for every friend you add. And this is all fine. Then set achievement image, a bucket, because real friends have buckets. I click on publish. I go to the website. I have 31 points. Now I want to add a friend. So I want to add Noah as a friend. Add as friend. What you see right now over here. Congratulations, you earned a new badge. I click on it. And I have a badge over here. Recently earned badge. Because I'm a good friend. And now I have 10 extra points. So if I go to the homepage, I have 51 points. Then I go to the dashboard, to Peepso configurations. I go over here, Badge OS. Enable Badge OS integration. Show badges link in the Peepso profile menu. Yes. Create a post when a user earns a new badge. So if I go to my profile, Ferdy earned a new badge, a good friend. You can do that. You can turn it off. Display recent badges on profile cover. over here or over here. Yes, how many? 10 is okay. Display recent badges on your profile also like that. So that's all fine with me. I click on save the settings and that's awesome. Now I want to show you something else. What you can do, we installed it already in the tutorial. We can sell things on our website. So if I would go to the dashboard and I go to products, add a new product. I can say Skype session with Ferdy. This is not for real. Just for the sake of the tutorial, it's a virtual product. Normally it's $300. This time it's $100 or it's pounds right now. I can change that. Inventory 000001. If you want to know more about WooCommerce, you can search for Ferdy WooCommerce on YouTube. And you find a tutorial where I go into everything about WooCommerce. So I'll just create a quick product. Skype with Ferdy. Add a category. Services. Edit. And then I want to have a product image. Search for Ferdy Corpus Hook. Open it, set product image, publish. And what we can do now here at, let me see, appearance, menus. So we can add the shop page, search for it, shop, add it to the menu, save it. If we go to the shop, you see over here, Skype session with Ferdy. And of course we can adjust it. That's what I will talk about in the tutorial. Add to the cart, view cart, and then we can proceed to the checkout. But what we also can do, we can let people buy things with their points. So that's another reason for people to be really active on this website, because they can buy a Skype session with me based on the amount of points they make. So how can we do that? We go to the backend, then I go to, let me see, points, add-ons, and I want to make the points a gateway so we can buy with them. I activate them over here. You can take a look at the documentation if you want to. Then we go to WooCommerce settings, and now we can change the currency to points. Scroll down. Here it says points. Save the changes. And now I go to my product, all products. And I do a quick edit because I want it to be 50 points. I update it. Then I go to the WooCommerce settings again, to payments, and I want to turn on Let's Pay using points. Save it, click on manage, perfect. I go to the website, I go to the shop, I have 52 points and this costs 50 points. I add it to the cart. View the cart. It says it's 50. My balance is 52. I click on proceed to the checkout. Fill in my details. And I click on place order. Now I have 2 points left. That means I bought a Skype session with Ferdy. Again, this is a fake thing, but how great is that? So people can get motivated to be active on your website, on your social media network. And then when they get a lot of points, they can buy things. And in that way, everybody's happy. So there's so much more that you can do. If I take a look at Peepso again, my downloads, my ultimate bundle, You can filter words. So if people say certain cuss words, you can filter them and block them. Email digest. You can send an email every week to all your visitors and show them what the popular posts are. You can make people very important. You can integrate it with Membership Pro and with Learn Dash, so you can add courses to your social media network. There's so much more you can do. I want to talk about the email digest, so I download it and then we will wrap it up. So I go to the backend, to plugins, add new, upload plugin, choose a file. Let me see, email digest. We already have it, I guess. So I go to install plugins, email. Yes. So what we can do, we can go to configuration, email digest, send email digest emails. Yes. The title, WP platform, email digest. Perfect. Send email digest to users inactive more than 7 days. Use images. Yes. How often should the email digest be sent? Every week, on every Friday at 10 a.m. Or you know what, 5 p.m. Because then the weekend start. How many posts should be included per one email? 3. Send email digest emails even if there are less posts. Include most liked posts and include most commented posts. No duplicates. Limit the post length in email digest to 200 characters. Awesome. Save the settings. And now we have set it up. So what else can we do? Of course, we can take a look to our configuration. We've looked to a lot of things already, but let's walk through it one more time. So the default stream filter is the community page. Open links in a new tab. Enable repost. Number of comments to display. Let's show 4. After how long should there be a read more button instead of the whole blog post? Let's say 500 words. Can we report things? Yes. And then we can say it is spam, advertisement, profanity, or inappropriate. We can get an email alert when somebody says some of these things are happening. People can say, remember me. I like that. So when people log in for the first time, they will be automatically remembered. Allow username changes. No. Clean up third-party registrations. No. I can disable registration if I have a closed community. We talked about this already. My license key. Let's make sure you have your license key configured over here. Then we go to appearance. I've shown you before, you can make it dark. So if I save that and I watch the website, it looks like this. I want it to be light. Then member listing on alphabetical order. Users can hide from the user listing. No. Allow guests to access the member listing. Yes. Only show members when something is searched. No. Allow searching users' email. No. Display people in their real names, and people can change their display name. No, I want them to have the first and last name. Like profiles. No. Avatars and covers. I want to show the avatars. We can make it compatible with the Divi builder. Here's the color scheme and the corner shape, square or rounded. Show notifications icon on the WP toolbar. Disable Peepso navigation bar. Yes. Replace the WordPress admin navigation bar. No. Use absolute dates. That means that it says posted on this date with this, with blah, blah, blah. I rather do not use that. I rather see this is 5 years ago or 3 years ago. Or how do I want to display my dates? Like this. Show the Powered by Peepso link. It can be an affiliate link, so you can make money when people buy it through your affiliate link. Show getting started in the admin menu. Show add-ons in the admin menu. Enable hover cards. Yes. Enable small link preview thumbnail. Yes. So if I post an external link, you see a little bit text about that page. Registration, customize the text, get connected. Come and join our WordPress community or platform. I think community is better, WP community. Join us now, it's free. I can change this image, save the settings. So that is this area over here. Then we go to the stream posts. Default post privacy is public. So normally when you post something, everybody can see it, or you can say only site members or only friends of mine can see it. Who can post on my profile? Only friends. Let users override the setting. Yes, if they want to. They can say nobody can add something on my profile page. Enable locations if you want to. They need to use the Google Maps API key. Enable moods. So right now, I can say I feel really flattered, cool, confused. I turn it on. Can people mention you? I will say yes. The hashtags, I enabled it. We talked about this already. Save the settings. Then let's take a look at the markdown. Can you make text bold? We can enable it. So you can make text bold, italic, inline code. Well, I will not use it. The blog posts, that's a totally different area. I will not talk about this. Edit emails. So when people are here for the first time, hello, welcome to the website. You can change those emails when accounts are being approved. When people like a post, you can change all those emails if you want to. And then of course, save it. Navigation. The homepage is the front page, the members area is this one. And if some page is not linked correctly, you can do that over here. But right now they're all linked, so there's no need to change it. When people log in, where should they go? You can say to the homepage. And when people log out, where should they go? Also to the front page, whatever you want. Then the live updates. If you turn this on, it will increase the server load. So I leave the settings as they are. And then we can go to advanced. Do you want to be GDPR compliant? SEO and Open Graph. I think this is all fine. When you want to change some things on the website, you want to be offline for a moment, you can turn this all on. Performance. Enable load more button. Yes. Or every 10 posts, load new posts. Storage, avatar size, how do you want to store things? Save some space on your website, compress things. And security, load link previews, yes. Allow none. SSL embeds, no. Enable external link warning, no. Domain whitelist, which domain can always be linked to. Login security, minimum password length, 10 characters. Enable login brute force protection, no. And here we can change our email. The admin email is this one. So this is all fine with me. And then here are a lot of settings based on the plugin. So if I go to the website, this is what we've created. A social media network where people can create their own profile, add images, post things for the newsfeed. They can reply on each other. They can love things from each other. They can add giphies. They can add hashtags, add photos. We can advertise. People can become friends with each other. People can create new groups. People can chat with each other. People can get points. And with those points, they can buy stuff. There is so much you can do. I want to thank you for watching this video. I hope you learned a ton of stuff and you're able to create a beautiful website yourself now. Good luck with your business or organization. And until next time, bye-bye.